the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. As we hear today in the synaxarion of this morning, and for the last 3 days, we are celebrating a lot of events regarding to St. Mark. So 2 days ago, 3 days ago, we celebrated receiving the relics of St. Mark from Rome to here by Pope Cyril VI. And today we are celebrating the inauguration of the Cathedral of St. Mark. Actually, St. Mark is one of the important saints in the church generally and for the Coptic Orthodox Church specifically, because he one of the disciples who wrote one of the Gospels. And he has a specific honor in our church because he preached us the Word of God. Without St. Mark, there would be no Christianity for Egypt and Africa and this area. So every time, and it's a good thing also to have the name of our church in St. Mark too. So it's a great blessing for us. So one of the great saints in the church, the St. Mark, we have to remember his name also in all the liturgical services. Like for the commemoration of saints, we have to mention his name, the first one after St. Mary and St. Stephen. So let's go back to the gospel of this morning. This blessed morning we hear the gospel of hearing the demon-possessed blind and mute man. The people brought him to Jesus and he healed him. And so the blind and mute man spoke and saw. Who is that man? This man represents the humanity. The humanity was under the control of devil before coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and healed the humanity. By coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, he changed everything. He fixed all our problems and mistakes, and he redeemed our sins to return back us to the paradise, to live with him forever. By his coming, he released us from the authority of the devil. He gave us freedom. He gave us freedom to love him and to live with him or not to do that. So how great is our God? After he shed his blood for us and for our salvation, he gave us the freedom to accept it or not. In our dealings with others, if someone did a favor for you, you live your whole life, remember that this person is did that things to me. Imagine if anyone like need a kidney transplantation and one of his friends or relatives like donate his kidney to him, how thankful this person will be to the donor. He will live his whole life, remember that he's carrying a piece of this person inside his body. So our Lord Jesus Christ did the same thing. He shed his blood for us, and after that he gave us his body and blood every day in the church to live with it. But my question here, are we really thankful for that? Do we thank Jesus that he saved us? I was talking to one of the persons. He's not Christian. And he told me something really, really important. He told me, you take the faith for granted. You don't know the value, or you don't know the value of your church, of your prayers. You don't know that. You took it for granted. You're born and raised as a Christian, so you feel that this is a normal thing. So, and sometimes we don't care about it. We come to church like it's a routine. We come to take communion because we have to take communion. But you are not thinking, how great is it to be a Christian, that we are saved. Somebody paid all our dues. He gave us his body and blood to live forever with him. He prepared everything for us. And at the end, sometimes we don't care about that. I don't care about God. I don't want to pray. I don't want to come to a church. Sometimes the people feel that being a godly person, this is not a freedom. It's a kind of slavery. I don't want to be with God anymore. The people thought that being with God is against their joy and their love and their life, which is not true. Because God wants all of us to be happy and joyful. So this person who was mute, blind, act crazy, this man represents all the people who follow the devil in their life. The people who refuse the freedom of God and get back to slavery of the devil. Gospel of this morning drew a clear picture of that person who live under the authority of the devil. This person will act crazy, will be blind, will be mute. So who is a crazy person? So when sometimes we're like, when we joke, this, you're crazy. So what does it mean? When you call someone crazy, it means he's act abnormally. He's doing something unexpected. He cannot expect, what can he do? He may something like he can harm himself and the others. We can call this person, this is crazy person. This is exactly what the sin do in our life. We act crazy. Because actually, we choose to walk in the way of sinner, the way of death, instead of being in the way of life. So when you choose to die, you are not normal. And when you convince yourself that you are doing the right thing, you are not normal. We can call you are crazy. As we used to call each other when we joke, yes, this is not normal. But this is the work of devil. He used to convince us that when we commit the sin, we're doing so. Let's have fun. This is fun. Let's do it. Or let's do it for some times and then we'll quit. Let's drink alcohol. Just have a party. Have a birthday, and this is just the start. And it will be a habit, and then you will not be able to quit. Imagine the people who used to take drugs, exactly the same thing. Let's have fun, let's try it. It's fine. Why not? One time is okay. And the second time will come, the third time it will become a habit. And when you start to be addict to those things, the devil will start to withdraw it from you. You will not be able to have it anymore. You don't have money. So you have to steal, have to do bad things. Maybe you have killed some person to take the money to have your stuff. Act crazy. Exactly like this man. This is the first point. To act crazy. To do unusual things. To gain the sin. And when someone called you, can you come to church? Can you pray? No, I don't want to do this. The people choose to be in the way of death instead of the way of life. The second thing in this picture is a blindness. This person was blind. Was not able to see the light. And exactly the sinner is doing the same thing. The people who commit the sin, they are away from the light of Jesus. They cannot see it. So they cannot discover their problems. And when you're not discovering your problem, you'll not be able to repent. Because to repent first, you have to discover that you have a problem. If you live your life as a normal person, you'll not be able to repent. I'm fine. I'm okay. I like myself like that. I like my life like this. I'm fine. There is no need for me to come to church or to repent or take communion or to confess. Old-fashioned way of life. There is no need for that. Another aspect of blindness is the devil will hide you the judgment day and the condemnation. He tell you, no, you will be fine. Do you think that there's a condemnation? There's a judgment day? No, there is no, nothing. You will be fine. Who told you that? You have a proof? No, we don't. And the next step will be, where is God? There is no God. To give you more freedom to do whatever you want. It ends up with denial of the presence of God. Spiritual blindness. You will not be able to see God. So you deny his presence. Spiritual blindness. And the last thing we can notice in this miracle. This person was mute, not able to talk. And the person who followed